Isn't that a very girly thing to say? You know, same thing with shoes. They hurt my feet and I cannot walk in them, but they look so pretty.
Funky, funky.
I want to wave my wand. Never mind. Never mind. Please forget that I said that. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I am playing with Makeup Revolution newness. Yes, as you can see, I have already done part of my base because that's not new. It's largely Makeup Revolution, but it's not new. It will be listed down in the description box. Okay, oh yeah, and my brows, it's weird. When I look in the, I'm trying new stuff. So I'm actually trying, what is it? The brow tint pen from NYX in the shade Ash Brown. Combined with one of those three pens, you know, one of these. Can you see? Yes, this one is from Kruidvat, from their own brand. And this is in the color Deep Taupe, which is actually a very, very nice color. But when I look in my monitor, my brows look red. But when I look in the mirror, they don't. So I don't really know what's happening there. We're just going to live with it. So, yeah. I will start with brushes. Sure, why not? So I have this one, which is new, but I have been using it quite a bit. And I kind of want to talk about it. This is there. R13 Soap Styler Brow Brush. And this is from their, I think from their normal Makeup Revolution line. This is a very, very nice brush. So on one hand you have a spoolie, on the other hand you have a brush. And the back of the brush I can use to basically really push everything against my head instead of using my fingers. The brush is very, very big, but still it does work wonders. So the spoolie side I use when I use my brow jam, and the brush side I use when I use a brow soap. That's my preferred way, and now I have it in one brush. I really do like it. So yeah, I will link it down below. The other brush that I got, Makeup no, X Revolution has launched a brush line, and I picked up one of the brushes. I did not pick up the face brushes because they are a little bit more expensive, and I, for Makeup Revolution that is, and I did not know if I would like the eye brushes. I don't know if they would be big or small, so I need to see some, maybe some reviews on it first, just to see how big those brushes are. But I got the Intellectual, the Petite Face Powder Brush. Here it is. It's a small handle, which I really, really like, and it is a, yeah, one of those flare brushes, and I love brushes like this. Now, I got one from Makeup Revolution before, which is from the same line as the other brush that I showed you, but this one is too stiff. They're almost the same size, but this one is stiffer than this one. These hairs are a little bit, have a little bit more give to them, and I prefer that. So this is too dense. I can use it though for, I can use it for a lot of things, but I usually not. Yeah, that's it. Let me compare to the other brushes that I use for my face. So here's the one from Sonia Kashuk that I usually use to set my face with, or to buff with my normal powder product. So you see the shape is the same, but it is smaller. It does feel the same though. So this one is also a little bit stiffer than the next brush that I will show you. And this one feels the same, but then in a smaller size. So I'm very, very curious about this one. And then the brush that I use for bronzer and blush, powder bronzer and brush, is one of these. I have two of these. This is a real haired one though. And that's the reason that I only have two. Because if they were synthetic, I would have had more. But I don't. So I have two, and I use these every single day. So yeah, this one is synthetic and this one is not. But this is a very, very flimsy brush, which I really, really love for blush, buffing out blush and bronzer. So I cannot wait to try this one. For a comparison, another one that I have here from Sigma, from their soft blend set. This is the biggest one. So this is the 60, which is way stiffer than this one. And this I like to set my face with, for instance, or my under eye, or this one from Makeup Revolution is almost the same, but a little bit less pointed, a little bit more round. Does that make sense? I hope so. Maybe that helps. I don't know. But yeah, I also picked up two cream blushes. So the super dewy blushes. They look a little bit more pink on camera though. For me, they are more, I think this is a coral, but I'm actually not sure. Let me swatch. So here is the shade, what's it called again? Fake the Flush. And let me kind of spread it out. So here it is spread out, and it, I think it makes, the camera makes it pink, but it is, I don't know, I think they call it a coral. So let me basically, they feel a little bit, they remind me a little bit of the NYX blushes that I have. Those are basically a cream to powder. This is a little bit thinner though. And I don't know, so here it is blended out. I think it will be very pretty on my skin, especially with my olive undertone. And then the other one is the shade Flushing For You. I don't know if these dry down completely though, so I'm very curious about that. And here, that's this one. So spread it out. It's darker and it is more, I don't know, I don't know the shade descriptions. It is less orangey though. And a little goes a long way. So here it is spread out, and I think I will use this one because it will, I think, complement the blush that I picked up the best. So I picked up another blush from X Revolution. I really like those blushes from them, and I have now, let me check, 4, I think. Yes, I have 4. So this is in the shade Entice, and this is what the component looks like. And here's the color. And again, the camera makes it a little bit more pink than it is. So I'm going to put it on my wrist below this one. So it's almost the same color, can you see? But then in a powder form, and this is a little bit more rosy almost. I think this was a peach that they described it as. So I'm very curious about it. Now, it is a matte one, and I love me my shimmer blushes, but this is a matte. So I pulled a powder bronzer and a powder highlight from X Revolution as well. They will be linked down below. What else did I get? I got 2 setting powders. Where did I leave them? Here. So I got an under eye setting powder. It's actually a new one. Yeah, from Revolution Beauty. What does the box say again? Brighten up your makeup by using this super fine pressed powder to dab down shine across your face or set under eye concealer in place. So this is what it looks like. And the component looks very pretty. Frosted plastic it is. And then the powder is very white. It feels very, very fine. So I'm quite curious to try that one. And you recommended this one, the Hydra Matte. So I got that one as well, and I'm very, very curious to try that one too today. And then, yes, and then Pièce de Résistance is an eyeshadow palette from iHeart Revolution. Look how cute this is. The Good Luck Charms. And the best part is, this is cardboard. It's a cardboard palette, which I really like. There is a mirror in it. But let me show you the color story. So here's the color story. And I like it. I think it is nice and springy. I like it. I was not planning on swatching it, but I think I will if I can get my sleeve up high enough. First off, I'm going to finish off the face. It does seem to dry down though. I don't want to say that it's very, very dewy. But that's maybe me. Yes. I am ready for... Oh, my close-up Mr. DeMille. I do want a little bit of Colourpop Wisp because I like that. And I usually just tap this on with my finger. Now, how do I usually use... Yeah, I want to use this one today. I already knew that I wanted to use that one. Usually I pick up at the off the back of my hand, so I don't dab on my face. So let's see. I think I want this brush because of the texture of the blush. So how do I use it? I put on the back of my hand. It's almost a moussey texture. And then I spread it around a bit with a brush. Make sure it's in the bristles, and then I tap it on my face. And the brush I have is from EcoTools. This is the Precision Blush brush, but I use it for cream, for thicker cream blushes, so like this, but also the NYX one. No, they don't smell the best though. Smell a bit chemically, which is not very nice, but that's okay. Yes, thank you. And then with a sponge, usually I pick the side that I have a little bit of foundation still on and just go over the edges a bit. Do I want a little bit of cream bronzer? I think I do. I wasn't going to, but I changed my mind. So let me whack that on real quick. Okay, so that is that. Yes. Looks nice. It does give me, or maybe I am very much mistaken. It looks like it does give me a little bit of luminosity, which is nice. But it could also be the highlighter. Yes. Freckles. I'm going to whack on my freckles now. So, I am ready to set the face. So, I'm going to set my eyes first, because that's what I usually do. And I usually use a brush like this, or at least lately. Which is the Sigma Soft Blend number 40. Ooh, picks up a lot. I'm not used to that. Okay, and it does seem to brighten, or am I mistaken? But it also seems to make my under eyes look a little bit drier. Okay, I think this is user error, because can you see what's happening there? Can you see that? I don't know, but I did not tap out my concealer well. It does set it very, very quickly and very well, but I need to make sure apparently that I tap out even better. Yeah, we will fix that later. Okay. Also doing my nose, side of my nose, and here. Yeah, it does set it, and I don't need a lot. So that is good. I will keep on using this, but I do think that this could be something that I would like in summer. I don't know if I like it for my under eyes though, because for my under eyes I usually grab a different powder, but that's okay. So that was that. I'm very excited about this one, the Hydra powder. I love their Infinite Loose powder. It's a bit. So I'm very curious about this one. Okay. Shall we try this brush? Because why not? And I'm basically doing this. And then a lot of the time I actually do this to get the excess off a little bit, and then I powder my face. I want to say it feels refreshing, which is kind of weird for a powder. It is so finely milled, it floats in the air. Powder, so far, let me check my big ass magnifying 5x mirror, because I'm curious. They're looking so bad. They are looking so, so bad. And I actually think it is user error, but I'm not sure. It seems to catch on the concealer that I have, but I also brought up my foundation, because I usually do. But it seems to have caked up, I don't even know if you can see it. It seems to have caked up my concealer. Which it doesn't feel dry though. It doesn't. Maybe I will like this powder underneath my eyes as well. If it's a Hydra powder. Yes, I know I'm caking on the powder. Or at least that's what it looks like. Yeah, well, it is what it is. Okay, so first impression on the under eye powder. Yeah, I truly think it's user error. I need to try that one out more, but I think for my under eye area, I prefer this powder or even this one, because this one feels very nice. That's it. It feels very nice. Now, I adore their normal powder, so that's not really weird. Let's do bronzer highlighter. So for bronzer, I have the X-Revolution in demo. Okay, so that is that. Yes, you go there. Then for highlighter, I also grabbed X-Revolution, and this is in the shade Strobe. Well, you know what I do wish though? That the components of the highlighters were different colors. So actually more the color of Wisp. That kind of, I don't know, champagne-y color. I wish that they had done that. Yeah, so highlighter first. That's my preferred method. Highlighter first, concentrate it here, blend it down, and then the blush goes on top. Oh, this brush picks up a lot. Maybe I need more of these, because I think I really, really like this one. Yeah, I really like this one. Oh, I'm so happy that I found an alternative, a synthetic alternative for the brushes that I love so much. I'm going to grab the powder, the hydro powder, I'm going to buff with it. So basically, I'm going to blend it over to blend everything in. I usually don't do this with my normal powder, but I think I can with this one. Okay, so yeah, love the brush, love the setting powder so far as well. I do feel it drying a bit, and I don't want to. I have a base fixer from Makeup Revolution, but I actually don't want to use that. I'm going to go to Essence Hello Good Stuff 3-in-1 Face Mix Hydrate Fix and Refreshes with Watermelon Extract. It's also new. It has a very nice fine mist. And it smells lovely. They also have a fan, by the way, Makeup Revolution. I'm not fancy like that. I just have a very cheap Neoni fan. Do I have the room to swatch? I hope so. So let's do live swatches again, because it has been ages. Oh, let's prep the eyes as well. What's the primer I want to use today? Shall I use the Kiko Milano one again? Or shall I use the Natasha Denona one? Because I have been using that a lot lately and I really, really like it. So let's do that. Let's prime the eyes already so it can kind of settle a little bit. I actually am getting very, very annoyed by my earrings. I don't know if you can hear them on camera, but they constantly tingle. And I'm not used to that. And it's kind of driving me bonkers. But they look pretty. Isn't that a very girly thing to say? You know, same thing with shoes. They hurt my feet and I cannot walk in them, but they look so pretty. or a coat. I have it with one of my winter coats. I love that winter coat, but it has almost no pockets. Why don't we have better pockets? What is that all about? You know? Let's get swatching. Again, it has been ages since I live swatched, because usually I swatch beforehand. So let's get a cloth. Let's get a little bit of spray. Yes. I think I'm just going to start here and go like that. Okay, so right off the bat, the shimmers feel really, really nice. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, wow, not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Maybe I need to... Why are you on 6.3? Usually you're on 7.1, right? Yeah. Is this better? I think it is a little bit better. I don't know why it wasn't 6.3, but that's okay. Okay, so I have here a microfiber dry cloth that I will clean my fingers on. Okay, so I kind of want to build this one up a little bit. This is more of a traditional shimmer almost. You know those old school shimmers? Oh, those are pretty. Okay, I'm going to build this one up a little bit. And I'm going to do this. Okay. The shade Wishbone, the last one, I don't think you can see. Oh yeah, you can see it. I think it's here. It's very light, but the undertone is gray on me, so that's it on my finger. But here's the color story. The only shimmer that I found swatched thinly, really thinly, was this one, which is the shade Serendipity. The rest is actually okay. Here is the black. Let me build up the black a bit. It's not a bad black. And it doesn't feel very, very dry, which is good. And that kind of means, at least in my book, that they are usually a little bit easier to work with. It kind of almost looks like it has maybe a hint of a sheen in it, which only helps with blendability. Yeah, let's start with the shade Fade. I'm thinking. I'm going to start with the shade Fade. I'm going to stamp the shape first. Oh, my under eyes are looking atrocious. It has been quite a while since they looked like this. If you want to know why I place my eyeshadow like this, I will link a video underneath the card or down in the description box, or maybe both if I don't forget and feel fancy, in eyeshadow placement for older eyes. And mine are deep set, but if you have hooded lids, you can still use the technique. I'm just going to bring my eyeshadow a little bit more down today. So here it's not set, or it is set, and here it's not. Oh, not too shabby. Okay, let's go for a different brush. Is this one the E25? I think the E27 is smaller, right? Where is it? Where is it? Here it is. Yes. I'm going to go to the Sigma E25. Still the same shade. And let's put it on the eye. Let's see. It's not too shabby. I did not think that it would. You know, to be honest, I like I Heart Revolution. I really like their Tasty palettes as well. But you know, quality-wise, it is just, yeah, it's a cheaper makeup, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. But that also means that I have certain expectations, and it actually surpasses them. This is quite a funky color for a drugstore brand. And I do need to pack it on because it is such a light shade. Now, if I were to use a denser brush, I could pack it on more. I'm going to go to a smaller brush, and I'm going to go to the shade called Lucky, which is the dark green matte. I'm going to deepen up with that. So I'm going in slow because it picks up quite a lot on the bristles. I don't want this as high up as the previous shade. I'm just blending the two layers together a bit. Okay, that's nice. They blend into each other very nicely, and I don't feel like it's getting patchy, at least not with the technique that I'm using right now, which is a combination of swiping and tapping. But I do want to build it up, and for that, I'm going to go to a different brush, one that is a little denser. I'm actually just tapping it into place because I don't want a lot of fallout, and then in the crease, I'm going to build it up. Okay, so they layer. That's nice. How do they blend? And now I'm concentrating on the green first to blend the two layers together a bit, and then I'm going to go back to the first shade. I'm going to go to the darker green for underneath my eye. And then I'm cleaning this brush and I'm going to go to the first shade. I'm going to blend it out a little lower. My under eyes are looking atrocious anyway, so let's just make the best of it. And put some color there. Okay. I also want to use the black. But I'm keeping the black on the outer part. Okay, so I'm going to go to the shade called Karma. I have decided. I'm not using a glitter primer. Karma, yes. So let's see what happens with the brush that I have now. Let's use it dry first. That's nice. Let's spray. On the other side, and how do I do that? I load up my brush with eyeshadow and then I spray with water. Does it make it more foiled? It looks like it a bit. Shall we do bright green bottom? Because I can. So now I am going to grab a glitter primer because for my bottom lid, I do like to use a glitter primer. I'm just going to put a little bit on the back of my hand. Take a brush, put it on the bottom lid. And then I'm going to grab the shade Gems. I changed my mind. I'm going to grab that one. For eye pencil, I have here the NYX Vivid Brights Eyeliner in the shade Love, which is a, I don't know what kind of color. It's a blue, but it's a different kind of blue than what I have on my lower lash line. I think it's fun. It has almost a little bit more purple in it. I kind of want something pink in the inner corner. Why? Because I can. So I'm going to grab a brush. I'm going to go to the shade called Success. And that's going to go on the inner part of my upper lid, but not completely in a corner, but there. Now, what kind of look this is going to be, but at least it's going to be creative. I'm going to bring it up a bit as well. Because I find that if you put kind of a shimmer there, it opens it up a bit more. Oh yeah, let's go to the shade Midas. Same brush, it does not really matter. It's dry, let's put it here. And then I'm going to go to the shade Opulence, because I can. And I'm going to do the same thing, but a little bit more on the middle of my lid. And I'm still using these shades dry. Gives it a little bit more of an interest. Then I'm going to go to the shade Karma again, for here. Yes, and then I'm going to go to the shade Opportunity. There. I'm going to put that here. And a little bit on the outer corner so that it blends into each other. Oh, I don't know. It was a weird sentence, but that's okay. Now I need a highlighter. Let's use the shade Destiny, which is the silver. I'm using it dry though, because I don't like a very shiny silver. I think that's it for the eyes. What is happening here? I don't know. I couldn't stand how they looked, my under eyes, so I removed. I put on primer, I put on my color corrector and foundation, and then freckles and yes. So I'm actually ready to powder again, because I want to try it again. Now though, I'm just going to try it on top of the foundation and see what happens. So let's get a brush and very light. I'm just pressing in now. Let's see. Using the tiniest amount. Is it set? Almost. Tiny bit here. Let's let that sit for a while, and then I'm going to do the rest of my face now. But I did want to show you that I removed everything and basically tried again. So far, this looks better, but it still kind of does the same thing. So let's let it sit for a little while I finish off the face. Okay, so the falsies are not from Makeup Revolution, because I don't have any from Makeup Revolution. They are, however, from AOA Studios in the style Jean. And these are basically your traditional 3D foaming lashes. And I really, really like this style a lot. I'm glad I have backups. Yes, for lips, I combined a Revolution Satin Kiss Lip Liner in TGIF with the iHeart Revolution Honeycomb Lipstick. I also have the gloss, and I was thinking maybe I should put the gloss on, but I thought, no, let's put the lipstick on. So yeah, here it is. It's very, can you see how cool toned it is? But when you kind of combine it with a lip liner, you can play with it. And I like it a lot. It is a funky color. It's way grayer than their gloss. But if you are looking for a very cool toned light lippy, well, this can be for you. Yes, that's it. Let me go over everything that I used so far. Let's start. Yeah, I had already kind of said about this brush, right? Ever since I got it, I'm using it. I really like this brush. This could have been half the length, but I don't know. I don't really mind it too much. So yeah, so there's that. Let's go for order of application then. So let's go next to the cream blushes. Yeah, I really like them, especially this color. I think this color is very, very, very pretty. It looked to dry down. But I am going to try out the blushes, especially with the Fenty skin tint, because I love a cream blush, but no powder with that skin tint. So I am going to try these out more on different foundations. I want to set them and not set them. But so far, yeah, are they super dewy? No. And I'm actually very happy that they're not. Why? Because I don't want sticky cheeks. If I want sticky cheeks, I will put on a lip gloss on my cheeks, because you can. I don't want that. Now, I don't have long hair, so, you know, there is that. But, yeah, no. I don't want my cheeks to remain sticky. And it feels like it's drying down. It's not as matte as the ones that I have from NYX. So maybe then there is the dewy there. I know it's from their super dewy line. So maybe if you combine it with a dewy product underneath, it will become more dewy. But honestly, I have no idea why they called it dewy. I did say it though. So there's that. So maybe I shouldn't. But I do really like it, especially this color. I think it's very, very pretty. I think it's very complementary to my skin tone. And I cannot wait to try the other one out as well. So for to recap, the one that I used is the shade Fake the Flush. Could you put on the letters any tinier? Smaller. That's the word. Wow. Yes, I have contacts in. I almost need my reading glasses on top of that. It's not sexy. Well, maybe some think so, but I don't. The other shade that I got was... God damn it. Now, why? Flushing for you. It does also does not help that the letters are shiny. Just saying. But yeah, I think that... yeah, I like them. So, but I love cream blush. I do want to kind of rank all my cream blushes, but I want to try these out a little bit more before I put them in a ranking video. So far, I think they're very, very pretty. You can build them up very nicely. You can sheer them out. Now, how the way that I use them with a brush is the most sheer, I think. I think that if you were to, like I did on my hand, if you tap it on or put it on your cheeks and then tap it out with your fingers, you get more coverage. I'm just, if I do that, it gets splotchy because I'm just not proficient enough for that, I think at least. I don't know. I like it with a brush. I feel I have more control with a brush. But that could be me. Okay, let's then next go to the setting powders. Let's start with this one, the under eye setting powder. Now that I have redone the under eye, it's way better. However, I can still here in the outer corner have, I have cakiness there. And I'm not really used to that anymore. So I don't really dislike this powder per se. So basically it reminds me of back in the day when I tried their... conceal and define concealer. Then I powdered it and I had such cakey dry under eyes, and this is kind of what it reminds me of. So I think it's the combination of the concealer and the powder that kind of clashes on my under eyes. Now my under eyes are older. They're not particularly dry, but they're not particularly oily either. They are maybe, they are on the drier side of normal. Does that help? I hope so. So I also feel it is, I feel it's a little bit better now. But I do think that in summer, I will like this powder. Now, in summer, for instance, I do set my lids because sweatiness, you know. I think I will like this powder then. I think that if you have oily eyelids or oily face, you will like this as well. It's very fine. But I did pick up quite a bit on the brush. So maybe that is it as well. I do want to try it out more. But I think that for me, under eye-wise, this is not my preferred powder. Which is, yeah, kind of a shame. But that's me. You know, if you don't have drier on the under eyes, if you don't have a lot of texture, maybe you will like this. But I think I will like this a lot in summer. Okay, let's then next go to the Hydra Matte Powder. I think this is a weird one. It's with hyaluronic acid. Yeah, but it feels... It doesn't feel wet. And I heard, what was that, the Becca one? No, who had that Hydra Matte Powder? I don't remember. But that kind of felt wet on the skin. This doesn't. But it does feel kind of cooling. It almost feels like you have a mister with a little bit of mint I don't know, that's how it felt. So I like it so far. First impression, I like it, but I like their normal conceal and define powder a lot. That's actually one of my favorite powders. And I think I will really like this one, especially in winter. So yeah, I'm very curious to try this one out more. Maybe I kind of want to try them side by side as well to see how that is. But yeah, it feels nice. It feels like my face. It doesn't feel powdery. So far, I like it. The blush, yeah, I love these blushes. And I really like the color as well. This is my fourth one. I will do a blush video soon because I want to go through my collection again. Okay, let's then go to the powder blush. I really like this brush. I really like this brush. I'm very, very happy that I have an alternative to my Sonia Kashuk one. And a synthetic option. Now, I think the Sonia Kashuk is synthetic as well, and I freaking love that brush so much. I do for blushes that are not as pigmented, or a shiny blush, or if I want to blow out my highlighter more, this is a perfect size. And I think I can also use it for powder bronzer, especially a powder bronzer that is maybe a little bit light. I need to try that. Yeah, and then lastly, the eyeshadow palette. Yeah, I think that the look came together very, very nicely. I just went, I don't know, I just played a little bit. So far, you know, these mattes and this one, I don't foresee any problems. Because usually those are colors that are very, very easy to formulate. That is why I started with this color, because I wanted to see what it did. Because it's kind of a funky color for iHeart Revolution. And I wanted to see what it did. And it did not disappoint at all. Now on me, especially with the base that I use, because the Natasha Denona base is a little bit more orangey, this one pulled bluer. And that is the same thing with teal as well. When I look at it now, and especially if I hold it against my my shirt, I know it pulls blue on camera, but can you see the difference? That if I hold it here, it pulls a little bit more blue. And if I hold it here, it picks up a little bit more of the purple of my shirt. So I think that if I were to use this one with, for instance, the ABH primer underneath, which is way lighter, but also slightly pink, I think this will pull a little bit more towards that lavendery side. So I think that is fun. This one did not disappoint either. I think both performed very, very nicely. Especially for iHeart Revolution. I actually think that so far these mattes are... Yeah, I think they're very, very nice. Truly. Feeling the shimmers. The only one who swatched thinly. Yeah, it's basically a little bit... This one swatched a little bit thinly. The shade Serendipity. And then here you have a little bit more of those old-fashioned shimmer shadows. So there are different finishes in here. Old-fashioned shimmer shadows. And then this one is a little bit more of your... The shimmer shadows that we are used to now. So a little bit more foiled. And then these two are even more intense and more foiled. Yeah, the shade Destiny. It's not something that I put on my eyelids. Because a very foiled silver is just... It does not look pretty on my eyelids. I find at least. But that doesn't matter. It is in here. And I will use it for inner corner work or something. Or dust it over the lid. But then dry, you know. I think it's a very pretty palette. Yeah, I'm very, very happy that I picked up this palette. I love the way that it looks. And truly, it makes me want to pick up the other ones as well. Do I think it's worth the money? Yes. Yes. I would even say I like this one better than the Tasty palettes. But that's purely because of the packaging. I wish that they would come out more with... I wish they would go with cardboard more. That's it. That is it for today's video, I think. Everything else that I used on my face will be down in the description box as well. And let me know if you have any of these. And if you have made it this far, leave me the glass ball emoji. It's a purpley one. And it is, where is it? I think in the objects section of the smileys. Yes, I think it's there. Leave me that one. And if you cannot find it, leave me a kitty cat. That's also good. So yeah, guys, that was it so far. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.